There was once a happy and adventurous family who decided to stay in their hometown this summer vacation. They went to a beautiful province where they can enjoy the beauty of nature and smell the wonderful scent of fresh air. When they arrived at their ancestral house, one of the daughters explored the place and found a huge farm. She decided to take an educational project and asked permission from her parents. They agreed with her great idea. The following day, after their thorough planning, she started planting together with her family. Around 2 months later, it was already a rainy season. So while waiting for the bountiful harvest time, she took a review on her lessons about weather. Let's learn it with her. Two weeks later, while the family was checking the crops, her mother told the family about lands. The father also connected the Bible lands, which can be found in the words of God. This inspired the whole family, and it was considered as their Bible study of the day. After waiting for a long, long time, finally, the day of harvesting came. Everybody was so excited, looking at the plenty of fruits and vegetables around them. The family was so happy picking different root crops and green leafy vegetables whilst thanking the Lord for the abundant blessings and great weather for the whole season of planting and harvesting. While they are packing things, her little sister noticed something, pointing out those fruit-bearing trees from a distance and wonder why they didn't harvest them. The father explained to her, "Well, that's because some plants are not yet ready. They are still growing and we need to wait for the right time." After an hour, while on their way back home, their father was also explaining to them the importance of the percentage of land area with sufficient harvest. When they arrived home, they helped their mother to prepare a nutritious meal using the vegetables that they harvested from the farm. Everybody was enjoying the food and feels delighted with a heart of thanksgiving and praising the Lord for the successful season of harvesting. There are three basic food groups, and they are the following. Go food gives us energy for work and play. They have fats and carbohydrates. Butter and cheese are sources of fats. Bread, rice, and pasta are rich in carbohydrates. Next, we have grow food. It helps us grow tall and strong. They are rich in protein. Protein-rich foods build muscles, and they can be found in meat, chicken, peanuts, and beans. Last but not the least, we have glow food. It keeps our body well. They are rich in vitamins and minerals. They help us maintain good eyesight and healthy skin. They also prevent many diseases. Fruits and vegetables are glow foods.
What is a tale? A tale is a story with unbelievable elements, related as if it were true and factual. Some tales are exaggerations of actual events. For example, fish stories, such as, "That fish was so big, why I tell ya, it nearly sank the boat when I pulled it in." The Canterbury Tale. A knight there was, and that a worthy man, that from the very time he first began to ride abroad, and loved high chivalry, truth and all honor, freedom and courtesy, and in his bearing made is a maid. He never had in all his lifetime said an ill-bred word to serf or man of might. He was a very perfect gentleman. Si Emilio Aguinaldo ay isang Pilipinong politiko at revolusyonaryo. Siya ay nanungkulan bilang unang pangulo ng Pilipinas at kinikilala bilang kauna-unahang pangulo ng konstitusyonal na republika sa Asia. Noong 2019, ikalabing dalawa ng Hunyo, nagpunta kami sa Kawit, Cavite para sa isang pang-edukasyon na paglalakbay at aming ginunita ang pagdiriwang ng 121 araw ng kalayaan. At kasabay nito, ang 150 kaarawan ng kapanganakan ni Emilio Aguinaldo. Mayroon kaming napakagandang karanasan doon kahit na hindi kami nakapasok sa loob ng museo dahil ito ay sarado sa mga oras na iyon. Sa halip, kami ay kumuha na lamang ng maraming larawan sa labas nito, lalo na sa bantayog ng ating magiting na bayani. At isa ito sa maituturing kong masayang paglalakbay aral kasama ng aking mahal na pamilya. Mapalad ang bansa na ang Diyos ay ang Panginoon. Ang bayan na kanyang pinili sa ganang kaniyang sariling mana. Mga Awit, Kapitulo 33, Versikulo 12.